we are going to show her our best bulldog strong behavior and attention. Please put your pencil inside your writing notebook. If you are one with a checklist, also put that inside of your writing notebook. And then you may put that to the side. If you feel like it's going to be super distracting to you, you may put it on the floor or inside your desk if you're one of those spots. All right, friends. So this is Caitlin.
Hi.
And sometimes it goes out, so let's see.
I have one.
And if I can be quite honest with you, Caitlin, it may go back out again, but we can always pull it back up. All right. All right. There you are, friends.
So the topic that I'm working on is water pollution. Does anybody know about water pollution before we start?
I guess very
scared. It can kill a bunch of animals that live in the ocean.
Yeah.
It can make the water not good for any fish and birds or anything like that.
Yeah.
If the water gets into our water sources, we could become sick.
Yeah. But
what's pollution in the water?
When you pollute the water can start when it evaporates, the chemicals get onto the ground, and then it's like if people walk near it, like if it gets in like a puddle, somehow when people walk near it, it can get the chemicals can turn into like a more air-like thing, and then it can inhale and die.
Yeah. Okay.
That's
funny.
Water pollution usually starts by oil in the car, like the gas, and usually, sometimes like a little bit of pollution, sometimes it's in our drinks, but like it doesn't hurt us that much because it's not much.
Yeah. Okay, those are great examples, guys. So I wrote a story of these two kids named Kate and Kay that found a piece of trash out on their playground, and they tried picking it up, but it flew away, and there was all this trash everywhere, and they were starting to think of how it was killing everything. So they went out and helped clean it up, and the animals came back out. Okay, so Kate and Kay go out to help. The big day. One day, Kate and Kay went on the playground to play. They noticed something next to the trash can that appeared didn't make it in the trash. Kate and Cade went over to pick it up and throw it away, but it flew away. There it is again. While they were playing in Cade's yard, they saw that piece of trash again, but now it was in the water. They started thinking about a fish or a duck eating it. What do you guys think will happen if a fish or duck eats it?
They'll die.
Trash all around. As they walked farther, they found more trash all around. It smelled terrible. Just imagine what it was like for the fish and the things that live in the lake. It's probably killing them. How do you think it smelled?
Terrible.
Yeah. Terrible. Clean up. The next day, Kate and Cade went back to the lake and cleaned the trash up. The lake was clean and the fish and turtles were back out. Kate and Kay felt happy that they helped the animals in the lake and hope to help other lakes they see with trash in them. Water pollution is hurting us. Just in Colorado Springs, 80,000 people are being warned for water pollution. Water pollution can be formed by dangerous chemicals in our water or trash being thrown in. The levels of the chemicals in the water are very dangerous. It is expanding and will soon be in our city water supply. But we can stop it. If you and a parent go down to the lake and pick up just a piece of trash, it will make a huge difference. So, I need help.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to show you guys a video about water pollution that will explain more about it.
Yeah. contamination of water by harmful substances which affects life on Earth is termed as water pollution. Due to human activities, our water is getting more and more polluted day by day. Household garbage is disposed into various sources of water. Many people perform their domestic activities like bathing, washing clothes and utensils, etc. in these sources of water. Also, industrial waste are discharged into the water, leading to water pollution. Consumption of this polluted water leads to diseases like cholera, typhoid, diarrhea, etc. in human beings. Polluted water also adversely affects the aquatic life. Thus, we need to make sure that we do not pollute water. Domestic activities like bathing, washing clothes, and utensils should not be done in rivers, lakes, ponds, etc. Household garbage should not be disposed in the various sources of water. Also, sewage and industrial wastewater should be treated before discharging into the water.
Now I have a trifold to show you guys. So from watching that video, what did you guys learn?
That most...
Do you want someone to help you hold it?
Wash your clothes in the water.
Yeah. We learned that, that the bait, that like when people bathe in lakes and go and whatever that other guy was doing can cause it, the water to get like all the dirt would get to the bottom of it and make it, the whole bottom higher, which would cause the thing to go up into our water sources, and then when they drink the water from their sink, it gets, it's the, they end up drinking the bad water and they can get really terrible diseases.
Yeah.
From what you guys just said, I'm going to explain what it is. So, water pollution is a contamination of water that humans create. It is created by chemicals that go down the drain, toilet, and harmful compounds that are discharged in bodies of water, and most of the time it's from factories that wash chemicals down the drain. Water pollution is an important subject because water pollution affects our drinking water. What covers 70% of Earth?
Water.
Water. Yeah. Water. And isn't that important?
Yes.
Water pollution is affecting our water all over the world. Water pollution is harming humans and the natural environment. Do you guys know of any effects that water pollution has on us?
It's got really bad diseases because that could sometimes like possibly get so bad that nothing can stop it. It's basically invincible.
Yeah.
And it kills animals that can live on water.
So some effects of water pollution are deadly and some are dangerous. Chemicals are legally and illegally dumped into bodies of water by industries, schools, health centers, and marketplaces. Here are a few examples of some effects. Destruction of ecosystems. Do you know what that is?
Yes.
Yeah.
death of aquatic animals, diseases, and disruption of food chains. So, why is water pollution a problem? It's because, like, we're basically creating it, like, we're creating it, and then we're basically just creating something that's gonna, like, start killing the earth. Yeah. So, water pollution is a problem because it is wasting water. Over 2/3 of Earth is covered in water, and less than 1/3 of land covers the Earth. As our population continues to grow, our water supply and water resources are depleting slowly. And what happens if all the water's gone?
Ooh. We get so thirsty that our body can shut down and die. So the aquatic animals and a lot of other
things. Yeah, we can't live without water, can we? No. So there are many different types of water. Does anybody know any types of water pollution? So there is groundwater pollution that lets the chemicals to get to the soils, microbiological, which is untreated water, oil spillage, that are oil spills that causes death to the wildlife, nutrients pollution, that are fertilizers that go down the drains, oxygen depleting, microorganisms in water, suspended matter, chemicals that dissolve in water, surface water pollution, lakes and rivers in contact with the surface water, and chemical water pollution, chemicals that kill weeds and contain plants that get into the bodies of water. Did anybody know what those were? So, where do you think the oil and the stuff that gets into the water, where did those come from?
Okay.